Feel free to have a seat and we'll get started. Yeah. Right. Well, welcome. Namaste. I'm Emily Perry. Welcome. I'm so excited to be here. You guys are amazing. Yeah. So this is my favorite yoga space here. So really, yeah. Enjoy it. We'll do a little spin around for sure so we get to really enjoy the view. So I first wanted to just introduce the crew back here. So Jacob Duran and Maz here will be playing for us. They're known as Kalakar. Also, they have a few more members of their band, but they're amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. If you didn't see their set Thursday morning, they'll be back for sure. And they'll be playing for Anne's class, actually, tomorrow. So come to that. And I also want to just thank you all for being here. This has been just like an amazing Bhakti Fest. This is my favorite festival ever. And so it's amazing to be here with you all. And so we'll start in a nice, comfortable seated position. So when you're ready to ground down and close your eyes, maybe closing your eyes, but finding a way to sit comfortably tall. And just putting the hands down on the legs and closing your eyes and dropping into your breath. So the title for this class was Roots and Rasa Vinyasa. So it's this moment of rooting down to really expand and feel that inner spirit of devotion, which has been so fully present here at this Bhakti Fest. And taking a moment to align the spine so that the breath can flow through you. And then bringing your hands in front of the heart, which is Anjali Mudra, Prayer Mudra, just holding the space. So for me, this whole Bhakti Fest has been about this journey into the love of our own hearts, like diving into the cave of our own hearts and really sensing that devotion, not only to that which we love, but our own selves, our own path, our own practice. And for me, what comes up a lot lately is this Radha Krishna, this dance of devotion fully to our own lives. And so as we bow in here for a moment, let's set our intention for this practice, for this moment in time. How can we be this able vessel for love? So in the Bhakti Sutras, they talk about love is manifest where there's an able vessel. How can I be that able vessel? We're going to open with three ohms together, holding that space as we journey, right? So go ahead and let's take a deep breath, inhale. This ohm is to someone you love dearly. This one to all the hearts around you in this moment in time. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Beautiful. Releasing your hands, opening your eyes. Let's make our way to downward facing dog pose. And taking a moment perhaps to walk out your dogs. This might be your first class in a while. Or this might be your third class today. So take a moment maybe to walk out your dog, pedal out the feet. And once if you've taken more than one class today, yoga class, can you just inhale and maybe float your right leg to the sky? Just like get an idea. Yeah. Okay. Beautiful. Exhaling, foot to the floor. And just to even you, let's inhale, float the left leg to the sky. Big stretch. Downward facing dog, both feet down. As you next inhale, let's inhale, float the right leg to the sky, deep breath in. As you exhale, you're going to bend your knee and open and stack your hips. So getting really funky here if you like, the foot can go in circles, ankle or knee in circles. But really taking this moment to root down, right? So we're going to find our roots, we're going to get really clear in the body and space, and then connect with your breath, right? Now as you next inhale, go ahead, straighten the leg, flex your foot, spin your toes down. Take a deep breath, inhale, and as you exhale to each nose, forehead to knee, go ahead, curl it in. Beautiful. Now inhale, three-legged dog. We're going to do that two more times. As you exhale, bend your knee, open and stack your hips. Yeah, so that's the exhale. Inhale, leg straightens. Beautiful. Exhale, knee to nose. One more time. Inhale, right leg floats to the sky. Take a deep breath. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack your hips. Beautiful. Inhale, leg straightens. Exhale, knee to nose. Beautiful. Now, as you next inhale, three-legged dog, big stretch. Exhale, step your foot between your hands, Virabhadrasana, one warrior one. Back foot spins to ground. And as you inhale, your arms are going to float. So if you can, heel to arch alignment. So the back heel is down, and you're going to root down. So we're going to root down to rise, right? Really get really clear in the legs. Spinning your ribs, you're towards the beautiful musicians we have here. Humble warrior, as you exhale, the hands are going to come behind you. You're going to interlace the hands behind your back. Now tone the low belly. Inhale, reach your hands towards your back heel. Exhale, it's a big bow in, forward fold. Hands might reach towards the sky. There's also a new moon here. It's tomorrow morning at 1 a.m. So we've got a lot going on, right? Now as you exhale, draw your belly in. Inhale, arms sweep up. Virabhadrasana one. Just take this moment, sit down to reach up. And as you exhale, it's a vinyasa, hands to floor. Maybe it's plank pose. If you like chaturanga, or all the way to the floor. And either up dog or low cobra, tailbone's long. Exhale, downward facing dog. Ujjayi breath. Connecting in, root down. Inhale, left leg floats. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack your hips. Again, maybe foot or ankle in circles. So getting really clear in your body, right? Now as we inhale, leg straightens, flex foot, spin the toes down. Take a deep breath, inhale. Now as you exhale, it's knee to nose or forehead to knee. Uddiyana Bandha, tone the belly. Now inhale, three-legged dog, reach it up, beautiful. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack. So we're gonna finish this vinyasa. Beautiful, inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to nose. Beautiful. One more. Inhale, three-legged dog. We got it. We're warming it up. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack. So we're going to open it up. We're going to find that Shakti. Inhale, reach, 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 three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to nose. Forehead to knee. One more. Now on this inhale, the leg will float. Exhale, step through. Virabhadrasana, warrior one. Back foot spins to ground. Heel to arch. Inhale, arm sweep. So as you root down, right, as we sit into warrior one, remember it's a hip opener, right? It's this really deep sit into our own power. Right, Vira meaning hero or warrior. Now as you exhale, taking the hands behind you, interlacing the thumbs, the opposite thumb on top. Inhale, reach back towards your heel. Exhale to bow in, forward fold. Hands might reach towards the sky. Beautiful. As you exhale, draw your navel, and then inhale, float it up, Virabhadrasana one, warrior one, arms sweep up, reaching, sitting down to reach. Exhale, vinyasa, hands to floor, plank, maybe chaturanga dandasana or your vinyasa. So we all have different experiences in our bodies, you know, during this practice, during this festival. So just allowing yourself to stay in down dog if you need it, or stay in child's pose if you need it. Remember, those are always offerings, right? On your next inhale, come high on your toe tips, look at your hands. As you exhale, you're either walk or step or jump or float to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. And as you exhale, a bow in, forward fold. We're gonna go into ragdoll. So you're gonna bend your knees, widen your stance, toe heel your feet all the way to the edges of your mat. Grab your elbows with your hands and just hang it out. If you like, rock it out, swing, sway, side to side. You know, in Santa Cruz, we get really funky here, so feel free to get funky, just like, just call it in, right? What you need here is what you get to do, right? So allowing yourself that space. And then coming to center, bend your knees, release your arms, inhale, slowly roll your way up to standing. And then stepping your feet together, hands at the heart, Samasthiti. Keeping your pinky fingers connected, we're going to bring the palms open in front of us and just coming into this space of offering. So closing your eyes, rooting down. Can I make this practice an offering to my path, my dharma? And then sealing that in, hands to the heart. releasing hands down, inhaling, arms sweep up. So Surya Namaskar. Maybe gaze to thumbs. Exhale, swan dive in, forward fold. Uttanasana, gazing to shins, long spine. Inhale, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, step or float, chaturanga, or your vinyasa. You can go to plank pose. From plank, take an inhale. Exhale, halfway or all the way. You can hold plank if you're feeling it. Up dog or cobra, and as you exhale, blow it back, downward facing dog. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to take a Kali breath together. So you know Kali, right? We're going to come onto the balls of our feet. And as you inhale, you're going to take a deep breath. And as you exhale, you're going to take your heels to your floor, close your eyes, and you're going to stick out your tongue to go. So big exhale, heels down. One more time. Inhale, come onto the balls of the feet, close your eyes. Exhale, heels to floor. Beautiful. Inhale, right leg floats to sky. Deep breath in. Find your roots. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack. So this is the exhale. Inhale, three-legged dog, reach, 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 reach. Exhale, knee to nose. And you're going to stay here. You're going to bring your knee more forward. You're going to lift your chin. Step your foot through. Warrior one, step it through. Back foot spins to ground. Arms sweep up. Inhale. Beautiful. Exhale, Virabhadrasana two, warrior two. Open it up. Yeah. Come on in. Shoulder blades down the back. Bring the low ribs in if you can. Create this connection. Take this moment to feel your body in space. Yeah? Back hand to back leg. Flip your front arm open. Take a reverse warrior. Inhale. Beautiful. And then exhaling, it's either elbow to thigh or hand to floor, side angle pose. Uttita Prasthanasana. If you like, sweeping the arm to the ear. Can I be a long line of energy here? Right, can I be a vessel for Shakti? Can I open to that? Inhale, warrior two, come up, look at your middle finger, pause, get fierce. Exhale, vinyasa, hands to floor, plank. Maybe chaturanga. Up dog or cobra, heart lifting, you got it. Exhale, blow it back. Can I be like Krishna? Can I be the one who shows up fully, right? Inhaling, left leg floats to sky. Exhale, bend your knee, open and stack your hips. Beautiful. Inhale, three-legged dog, reach, stretch it out. Exhale, knee to nose, forehead to knee, hug it in. Now bring your knee forward, lift your chin, step your foot through. Virabhadrasana, warrior one, back foot down. Inhale, arms sweep. So let the breath be the guide. Exhale, open, Virabhadrasana two, warrior two. Spinning the knee towards the middle toe. Toes to 12 o'clock. Drop your tailbone. Low ribs in, right? Just, we're going to be a vessel for prana, for Shakti, for love. Okay, back hand to back leg. Flip the front arm. Take a reverse warrior. Inhale, you got it. Exhale, elbow to thigh or hands to floor. Side angle pose. Long line of energy. Find it right here. Inhale, warrior two, come up, sweep it up. Look at your middle finger, get clear, right? Get really clear. And then it's a vinyasa or a downward facing dog. Hands to floor, plank. Maybe chaturanga dandasana, maybe not. Urdhva mukha or upward facing, and then low back, downward facing dog. Beautiful, I love it. Can I be that vessel for love, the able vessel? Big toes touch and downward facing dog. Big toes touch. You're going to inhale, come onto your tippy toes. Look at your hands, get clear. As you exhale, you're going to bend your knees, either jump or step or walk or float to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, it's a big bow in, forward fold. Inhaling, it's chair pose, Utkatasana, just for old time's sake, chair. Yeah, because you know you love it, right? This is your favorite pose. And if it's not your favorite, it's your neighbor's favorite, okay? So this is what we're going to do. We're going to turn the palms to face Jacob and Mas. Okay? You're going to inhale, take a deep breath. As you exhale, you're going to sweep your arms through. You're going to sit down and get really low. Yeah. And then inhale, Utkatasana, sweep it up. Exhale, draw it through. Clearing the space. Inhale, arms sweep up. Keep going. Exhale, blow it through. Inhale, Utkatasana, last one. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Now, some of you might have a Bakasana Vinyasa, so you might take your hands down, knees to armpits. Maybe you take your knees to your arms, crow pose, float back, chaturanga, or it's your vinyasa. We'll meet up in downward facing dog. or not. You can always tap out. Say, yeah, yeah. Tap out. I will throw an arm balance in everywhere that is possible, and so feel free to skip it. Okay. I'm just going to do the disclaimer now. All right. Inhaling, right leg floats to sky. Take a deep breath. Beautiful. Now as you exhale, it's right knee to right elbow. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. Take it to your left elbow. Come on in. Inhale, three-legged dog. Big stretch. Big stretch. Exhale, step through. Warrior one. Virabhadrasana one. Back foot down. Arm sweep. Inhale. Root it down right here. As you exhale, let's open Virabhadrasana two. And you're going to pause here for a moment. Spin both palms to the sky. Okay? Soften your trapezius. Soften your upper shoulders. Okay? Sink your hips. So we're rooting down. Oh, look, we have like the whole crew coming to say hello. This is awesome. Okay. Back hand to back leg. Flip your front arm. Reverse your warrior. Hey, Aruna. Take a deep breath. Inhale. So make this offering to them. Okay. Right here. And if you exhale, either elbow to thigh or hand to floor, side angle pose with the arms here. Here they come. Inhale, Virabhadrasana two. Go ahead and make your way up. And let's say hello. Slide your back hand down your back leg. Take a deep inhale. Now as you exhale, you're going to reach out and away for triangle. But don't take your arms to your leg just yet. You're going to reach out. Make it an offering. Now you can take your hand to your leg if you need to, or you're going to make it this pranic experience when you reach both arms out, hold your pranic ball. And then maybe the arm releases to the leg, opposite hand to sky. Uchita Trikonasana. Tailbone's long, low belly's in, roll open from the heart. From the heart, beautiful. Inhale, warrior two. Go take a look at all these beautiful people. Aloha. Exhale, vinyasa, hands to floor plank. Maybe just hold plank and just say hello. Chaturanga. Up dog or cobra, heart lifting. Oh, low back, downward facing dog. Let's take a big ohm together at down dog. So go ahead, close your eyes, take a deep breath, inhale. Beautiful. Inhaling, left leg floats to sky. Exhaling, left knee to left elbow. Sweep it to your right elbow. Inhale, three-legged dog, big stretch, reach it up. Virabhadrasana one, warrior one, step it through. Foot between hands, back foot down. Inhale, arm sweep up. Say hello to the beautiful hearts. Oh. Exhaling, opening Virabhadrasana two. Yeah, all right. Palms up in this offering of love. So palms up, soften the shoulders. Right, so just saying hello. Back hand to back leg. You're going to reverse your warrior. Inhale. Exhale, elbow to thigh or hand to floor, side angle pose. Yeah. Long line of energy. Now as you inhale, sweep back to warrior two. Come back up. Look at your middle finger. Look at these beautiful faces. You're going to inhale, straighten the front leg. Okay. So the reverse triangle. Back hand to back leg. Palm open. Inhale. It's a big stretch. Exhale. You're going to reach out. Make the offering. Reach it out. Either stay here, if you might, or if you can, fine. You might sweep your right arm over your ear and hold it out. It's this moment of like offering it up, right? Offering it up. And then maybe it's hand to leg, opposite hand to sky, triangle pose. Find it right here. Uttita Trikonasana. Can I spin open from the heart, right? Can I be in that space? Warrior two, inhale, sweep it up, look at your middle finger. Exhale, hands to floor, vinyasa, plank, baby chaturanga. Up dog, cobra, heart lifting. Downward facing dog. Knees to floor, hips to heels, child's pose. Palms in front of you, palms to sky. And coming back to this space of offering. Can I offer up my own practice? My own heart. As you next inhale, we're going to come to all fours, Anahata Asana, puppy dog. You might know puppy dog. So the knees are over the hips are over the knees, and your arms are going to reach out. Now, some like chihuahua, so I call this one chihuahua, forearms down. You don't have to bark. If you want to bark, you may. Or you're going to reach out in front of you and melt your heart. So it's that full melting. Radha being the doorway to the heart, right? As we call her in, as we call Krishna in, this ability to show up fully for our own lives. As you next inhale, you're going to look forward. You're going to come onto your belly, all the way onto your belly. Hands are under shoulders. We're going to set up for three cobra waves. And so being in this space of Bhujangasana, this offering of the heart. So hands are under shoulders. You're going to inhale. Wave yourself up. Look over your right shoulder. Exhale, bow it up. Inhale, wave it up. Looking over your left shoulder. Tailbone long. Exhale, wave it down. Last one. Stay facing the front. Inhale, tailbone long. Heart's going to lift. Can I open the doorway to my own heart? Exhaling, coming down. Downward facing dog. If you like, press through chaturanga or not. Downward facing. Big toes touching downward facing dog. You're going to inhale onto your tippy-tippy toes. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward. Stepping or jumping or walking or floating or crawling to the front of your mat, whatever you need. Halfway lifting down. Exhale, the big bow in, forward fold. Anugustasana. So you're going to bend your knees, toe heel your feet, two fists width apart. Keep fingers to big toes. Inhale, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold it in, forward fold. Elbows come to the sides, and you're going to hang it out.
Yeah.
If you need ragdoll here instead, feel free to go to ragdoll.
Krishna.
Listening to this beautiful soundscape. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, take your hands to your hips. Okay, put your belly into your spine. Put your shoulders on your back. Inhale, come all the way up to stand. Beautiful. Feet together, tree pose. So left foot's gonna root. Right foot's gonna lift. Either low tree or high. And if you may, fingertips. Our finger, pinky fingers come together. This space of offering right here. Can I offer up the prana of my practice? And maybe from there, the arms fold over the head, you like tree pose. Root it down. If you want to create branches and leaves, feel free if you like to add a backbone today. Make it this emotional offering. Heart. Feet step together to touch. Vinyasa, hands down, inhale, arms sweep. Exhale, swan dive in, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step or float, chaturanga, your vinyasa. Hold me feet up, downward facing dog. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, right leg floats to sky. Yeah. Now, so exhale, step it through for low lunge. Back knee releases to the floor. Keep your toes tucked. Arms are going to sweep up as you inhale. On Johnny Asana. So drop your tailbone toward your back heel, okay? And there's a sense of connection right here, okay? As you drop the shoulder blades down the back, take the low ribs in. And then again, making this offering and devotion, if you like tailbone long, belly back, start to curl it back. Inhale. Exhale, hands to floor. The left hand's gonna stay down. Tuck your left toes, lift your left knee. Now take this moment to connect, inner thighs connect, hug the midline, okay? And as you inhale, right arm is gonna float to the sky. Shoulder to shoulder, wrist to wrist, beautiful. Take a deep inhale, exhale, hands to the floor. Plank pose, step back. All right, so here we go, you ready? Yeah, all right, plank pose, yeah? Now as you inhale, get clear. Now as you exhale, listen, it's right forearm to the floor, left forearm to the floor. I know, just for a second. Yeah, forearm plank, you got it. Now, so don't get cozy, because you're gonna inhale, right hand down, left hand down, high plank. Yeah, downward facing dog, go ahead, lift it up and back. I love you too. Inhaling, left leg floats. Deep breath, exhale, step it through, low lunge. Anjaneyasana, back knee down. Inhaling, arm sweep. Ujjayi breath. Drop your tailbone, lift your heart. Take a deep inhale. Now the belly might come back a bit. You might just start to curl back. Take an inhale. Find that space in the front of the heart. And as you exhale, the hands release to the floor. Right hand down, tuck right toes, lift right knee. Inhale, lift the back knee, and the left arm floats to the sky. Don't worry, it'll come back to tree on the way up. Shoulder to shoulder, wrist to wrist. Now, wrap the shoulder blades down your back a bit more. Spread your collarbones wide. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, hands to floor. Plank pose, step back. Inhale, exhale, left forearm to floor, because we've got to be even. Right forearm to floor. Plank pose, low plank. This is it, right here. Left hand down. Inhale, step it up. High plank. I love you. Downward facing dog pose. I got to get you ready for Krishna Das. Okay, big toes touch. Inhale, harden your tippy toes, look at your hands. Exhale, bend your knees. Step, jump, walk, float it up to the front of your mat. Halfway lift. Oh yeah, well, good job. Forward fold, exhale. Reverse swan dive up. Ground for your feet, lift your heart. Gaze above. Exhale, hands to heart, follow the seat. Rooting down through your right foot, left foot's gonna lift, true pose. Bricks off to the second side. And just dropping into this moment. Right here. This is it. Maybe making that offering. Fingertips together. Being the able vessel, right? And maybe now the arms might float overhead. Bricks off to the root down to rise. Hands come together to their part, to the heart, and then feet step together to touch. We're going to turn ourselves around, and you're just going to look at this great canyon for a moment, stepping to the front of that edge of your mat, so walking yourself up there. Hands maybe coming into that offering place, or hands over the heart, and just closing your eyes. Sound with your inner ear. Being in this space with our inner jyoti, our inner vision. Just walking through this practice, stepping through this practice of yoga together from this inner place. Okay? So keeping yourself facing this direction. On your own, taking one salutation to this beautiful sun that will be setting soon, to this beautiful heart that you have, that all of us have, right, beating, to every heart in this desert, making this as offering, every kangaroo rat that you might see, every world runner you might see out here, this is this offering to this great desert, which is really this ocean, devotion, hands down, inhaling, arm sweep up. So this is your namaskar, whatever you want it to be, as you exhale, holding it in at some point. We'll meet up in downward facing dog. Inhaling, perhaps hug lifting. Exhaling, it's a bow in. Can we show up fully in this moment? We'll meet up downward facing dog. Right leg floats as you inhale. Go ahead, take it up. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Same thing, back knee down. Inhale, arms sweep up. Beautiful. Now this time as you exhale, we're going to take the hands to either side of the right foot. And we're going to come into half Hanuman. So the hands are going to come down, and you're going to exhale, you're going to fold over your straight right leg. And I have to take three little pulses here. So you're going to inhale, halfway lift, little Ardha. Exhale, bow it in. Three waves on your own. So you're still in half Hanuman, but you're just waving it up. A little spinal wave. Inhale, partially lifting. Exhale, bowing it in. It's a bow of devotion. One more time. Inhale, halfway lift, if you like flexing those toes. Yeah. Exhale, bow in. Beautiful. Inhale, walk it out back to low lunge. Now both hands are going to come inside your right foot, and you're going to toe heel your right foot to the edge of your mat. Turn your toes to 45 degrees, back knee is on the floor. If it's not already, keep your back knee down. Yeah. Now this is lizard pose. You can stay high, or you're going to go low. You might go low, forearms down perhaps. This is your low lizard or high lizard. We're going to breathe into these areas of constriction, of tension, these old patterning that we often have in the hips. Breathing in. Holding that space. Beautiful. As you next inhale, walking your way up. Okay. So we're going to step our left hand wide on the left edge of our mat. Toes are still at 12 o'clock. Come right here next to you guys. And you're going to step it wide. Now, I'm going to take my right hand to my right thigh. And I might stay here, or it's a belly back. I'm going to drop my tailbone and start to curl back a little bit, open. You're going to stay here, or you're going to inhale. You're going to reach your right arm out behind you, thumb back up like a hitchhiker. You're going to reach towards your back heel. Reach, 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 reach. Belly back, curl back. Now stay here, or bend your back knee, grab your foot with your hands. You might stay here, you might inhale, get long, kick into your back foot, lift your heart, exhale, bow in, heel towards hip, you might fold in between that, inside that right knee a little bit, yeah. Inhale, kick open, one more, two more. Exhale, you might bow in, release your back foot if you need to at any time. We're going to meet up in down dog, one more time, inhale, kick back, lift the heart, deep breath, inhale. Exhale, hand releases down, tuck your back toes, lift your back knee. Downward facing dog pose. Baba Mukha. Let's take our Kali breath together. So come onto the balls here with me. Take a deep inhale. Close your eyes. Exhale. Stick out your tongue. Lion's breath. Right here, right now. Inhale. Heels high. Close your eyes. One more. Exhale. Lion's breath. Om. Let's take an Om together. Close your eyes. Root down. Take a deep inhale. Oh yeah. Inhale, left leg close. Exhale, step through. Low lunge. Back knee touches down. Inhale, arms sweep up. So if this concrete's fluttering your knee, yeah, feel free to double or triple your mat underneath that right knee if you need to. Inhaling, tailbone's long. Arms reach up. So as you exhale, hands to either side of your left foot. We're going to take our half Hanuman. We're going to exhale, bow over the straight left leg. And then it's three little pulses. Inhale, Ardha, halfway lift. Exhale, fold over the leg. Little pulses. Inhale, Ardha. Exhale, fold. It's the inner bow. One more time. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold it in. Beautiful. Now inhale, walk it back out, low lunge. Both hands inside your left foot. Toes turn out 45 degrees as you toe heel your foot to the edge of your mat. Beautiful. Now it's either high lizard or low lizard. You might say high, you might go low. Yeah. Stop your eyes and your jaw. Can I release what I don't need in this moment? Left hand to left thigh. And you might just start to curl back right here. Tailbone block. Curling open to this great deadlift. Stay here or inhale. Left arm reaches back. Thumb up. In reach. Expand the arms. Stay here or bend your back when you find your foot. It might be a quad stretch. Or you might join us with a holding Vinyasa. You might inhale, take open from your heart. Exhale to fold in. Inside your left foot. Two more. Inhale, take open heart lift. Exhale, bow. One more. Inhale, the big peeling open. This is great. Lifting open the heart. Exhale. Bow it in for four. Dance the floor. Inhale, plank pose. This is either a Vinyasa or downward facing dog. You're going to inhale, high your tippy toes. You're going to exhale, bend your knees, empty of breath, stepping or jumping or walking to the front of your mat. Halfway lift and half. Exhale, fold it in, forward fold. And then reverse swan dive up. So you're going to ground through your feet, inhale, arms sweep up, take a deep breath. And then exhaling, hands to heart center. Allow it to be the witness to our own devotion, right, which is so present for us here in this space. And then placing that left hand over your right hand and just feeling that in. Let's take another ohm together. Take a deep breath, inhale, seal it in. Side. So we're going to go to prostrata stance. So toes are going to be parallel. Big wide stance. Get really, really wide. Yeah. All right. Prostrata Padottanasana. We're going to inhale, reach the arms out by our side. As you exhale, interlace your hands behind your back. And before you straighten your arms, you're going to bend your elbows. Elbows pull out to the sides. You're going to inhale. Take a deep breath. Pull into the desert. As you exhale, folding in. Four, pull. Hands reach towards the sky, maybe towards the floor. The Joshua Tree, you might have noticed, is like this vortex, right? It's this amazing place where the sky and the earth come together in a really unique way, right? There's this energetic field here, it's different, right? It's powerful, you can feel it. Go ahead, release your hands under your shoulders. Inhale, halfway lift. Right, can I be in this space, fully present, in this moment? Exhale, folding in forward fold. Hands are going to walk out underneath you, perhaps. If you'd like, cross through the A, hands walk back. Some of you might float your way to tripod headstand. If you have a stable tripod headstand, and you want to slow down here. Otherwise, this is your forward fold. Taking a Bhaktifest variation, feel free. Or not. If you're a sure sophomore, personally, that's it. If you're a sure sophomore, personally, you're going to make your way down. Hands or legs reach down. Beautiful. We're all going to hit inhale halfway lift. Now, as you exhale, you walk your arms out in front of you like downward facing dog. So it's like a wide down dog. And walk your hands out so your upper body is in downward facing, right? Tense your fingertips. Create little teepees with your fingertips. Finger pads are down. And it's going to help relieve the wrist as well. You're either going to stay here or you're going to inhale, reach your right arm out. As you exhale, you're going to grab somewhere towards your left ankle. Or maybe not. You can skip it. Inhale, get long. Exhale, twist open from the heart. You're going to spin open underneath your armpit. I call this one like status check. So we get to check and see like what's happening in your armpit. Yeah, it's like, yeah. At Bhaktifest, it's all of us, right? Sweaty desert. Inhale, come back to center. Switching sides, right arm long, sweep your fingers, bend the fingers, inhale, left arm reaches. Exhale, grab the center of that right leg. Back to center. So walk your hands in, and you're going to take your hands to your hips. Okay, keep your back flat if you can. Belly to spine. Inhale, come all the way up to standing. Yeah, staying here. Okay. We're going to spin the heels in, and the toes are going to turn out. Temple pose. So I'm going to come over here. What? Towards Nico here. Come on, Nico. Temple. All right. Palms up. Close your eyes, drop in. Can I root down to raise the Shakti to the heart? Can I find my inner prana, right? Can I tap into the pelvic energy, right? There's just so much energy that we carry bound up. Can I clear it up, raise it up? Shoulder blades are down the back. Sitting in maybe a little bit deeper, making this your offering. So if you're feeling something in your thighs, this is what we call building character. Yeah. Yeah. It's good. We're rooting in. Beautiful. Now if you inhale, go ahead, straighten your legs. Let's step to the front of the mat facing Jacob and Maz. Samasthiti. Go ahead, shake out your legs if you need to. Facing over here. And then hands will release down. Inhaling, arm sweep up. Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale to bow, making hands towards the heart as you bow into your own practice, your own life. Inhale, halfway lift. Vinyasa, maybe Bhaktasana Vinyasa one more time. Or skip it, right? Downward facing dog is also an option. So Karen Mason-Miller, the front line, of course. Facebook friend, right? What does that mean? Right? She said, she's a writer, she's amazing. Bear attention and love. Can I be in bear attention right here? Beautiful. Inhaling, right leg floats to sky. Here we go, low lunge. Exhale, step through. Back knee touches down. Now this time, untuck your back toes, yeah? Inhale, come onto your back knee. Hands to hips this time. We're going to draw onto the back knee a bit and square up. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, lunges. We need two more of these. Again, inhale, back out. Go one long. Exhale, lunges. Last one. Inhale, back out. Drop the tailbone, tailbone long. Exhale, bowing in. Now try to have a little bit of space here. If you may. Arms are going to release down. Let go. Yeah. So here we go. This is my favorite way to get into the heart. So we're going to inhale, roll the shoulders up, and you're going to release the shoulders down, and you're going to reach back towards earth. So Umi, like the earth goddess, as your witness as you reach down. Tailbone long. Push into your back foot. Belly back. Reach back. Take an inhale. Now stay here. Or palms up. Inhale, offer up. Arms sweep overhead. Anjaneyasana. Right here. This one. Two. Belly back. Curl back. Even more. Can you? Offer it. Just one more breath. Take a deep inhale. Beautiful, exhale, releasing it down. Beautiful, both hands inside of right foot. Toe heel foot to edge of mat. Toes stay pointing forward this time. Tuck your back toes, lift your back knee. Ground your back heel like warrior one. Okay, so set it up like warrior one. Now, we're going to take down dog and warrior one. You can thank, like, you know, Sienna Sherman for this one. This is a fun one. You're going to reach your arms towards the left, so you're like in downward facing dog, but your legs are in warrior. So hands are on the floor. Does that make sense? We're cultivating our practice in these kinds of moments. Right? We're cultivating our practice in these kinds of moments. What's the mental message you're telling yourself? Besides me, my voice. Walk both your hands back and inside your right foot. Back heel is going to lift now off the floor. Lizard pose. Now here's the multiple choice. Okay, we've got a few choices. Choice one, child pose or down dog. Choice two is you're going to lift your hips a bit. Take your right shoulder under your right knee. Okay. Like where Anne's going. Hands are going to plant baby chaturanga stance. You might play with a bind here. You can also wrap your arms around your right thigh and hang out here for a few moments. Or, hands are going to plant on the floor when you're ready, just behind your right heel. So this is Ekapadaku Vinyasa, flying Radha, right? So the hands will plant, your toes go forward to the right, forward to the right. You might cover your foot, you might lift the back leg. Ekapadaku Vinyasa, stay here or float back chaturanga, or not. Up dog or cobra, meet up downward facing. Yeah. This is it. This is it right here. Inhaling left leg hook. Low lunge. Exhale, step through. Back knee down. Untuck toes. Come onto your back knee, hands to hips. Let's do our pulses. Space of offering. Take an inhale. Exhale, lunge it in. Two more. Inhale, back out, draw back. Tailbone long. Exhale. Walk it in. One more time. Now, as you drop the tailbone, belly back a bit. Exhale, fold in. Now, try to keep some space here. Beautiful. Now, inhale, roll your shoulders back. Tailbone long. And start to reach down. So it's like a big reach from the heart. Take that prana right down to earth. You can deep inhale. Stay here. Or palms to sky. Inhale. Heart to reach up. Can I make this my offering right here? Right? Can I open the door to my own heart? Take an inhale. Exhale. Hands down. Both hands inside of foot. Tuck your back toes. Lift your back knee. Set up for warrior one feet. So heel to arch alignment. Ground the back foot. You're going to walk your hands over to the right, downward facing dog, upper body in warrior one. This is that funky pose. So you're like in warrior. Yeah, two. Three. Walking your hands back into the front of your mat. Back heel lift. Lizard variation. So again, we're going to stay here. Toe heel foot to edge of mat, or maybe you can take your shoulder under your left knee. You might play with a little bit of a wrap and line around that thigh. Or I could put it pretty natural. Toes walk forward into the left, forward into the left, forward into the left, forward into the left. Flying right up. And then maybe step through a Vinyasa or downward facing dog. We're going to meet up in child's pose. You might know that one. Actually, it's being in prostration. You're going to come onto your belly. You're going to reach your arms out in front of you, palms to sky. Full prostration. Arms are out. Fully laying down. Palms up. Forehead to earth. Be the able. vessel. So you talk about tantra, we talk about the mulas, like the coverings of the heart. Can I do this work to uncover my own heart? So that I can be in a moment and not resist it. Can I be in my own life and not resist my own life? Maybe the palms come together in Namaskar, and you bend your elbows and take the palms to the back of the heart. So the elbows are going to bend, the palms will come towards the back of your neck or towards the back of your heart. And again, just making this offering to all parts of who we are, right? So your light, your dark, your shadow, the parts of you that are messy, the parts of you that are crabby, all parts of you. Allowing all parts of who you are to come in. Because they're all welcome here. Back to earth. And then coming up to sit on your shins. Feet together, knees can be wide. Or knees together. We're going to take a twist together. We're going to inhale, take a deep breath. And exhaling, twisting towards right, left hand to right thigh. Tailbone long. Inhale to center. Exhale, go the other way. Soft eye, soft jaw. Right, can we not resist our own lives? Beautiful. Now inhaling to center. This is called cowboy camel. Some of you know this one, right? So the knees are going to be wide. It's really not scientific at all. I'm just kind of go with the flow. But my right hand, I'll show you for a moment. My right hand comes behind me. I'm going to inhale, sweep my left arm, maybe a little. Or a lot. Exhale, sweep it through, and then we'll go to the left. Inhale, the right arm is going to sweep. Exhale, bring it through. Let's go together. Right hand behind. Inhale, left arm sweeps. Exhale, bring it through. Hand behind you. Inhale, sweep it up. Exhale, bring it through. So filling yourself with the soundscape from Jacob and Maz. Inhale, heart forward. Exhale, bring it through. Let's clear it out. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Hands behind you. Inhale. Offer it up. Last one. Inhale, right arm sweep. Exhale, bring it over. So you're hugging your mirror. Or the child's pose with the knees wide. So keeping your knees wide. Walking your hands out, sliding, bowing in. Bowing into this practice of yoga, right? So this is this long, long, long tradition, this long lineage. All these teachers that have come before me, before you, their teachers, teachers. Slowly inhale your way to all fours. This is a shoulder stretch. And it's going to go as deep as you like. So as we inhale, the left hand will stay down. The right arm's going to reach out as you inhale. And then the exhale is right shoulder to the floor. You can straighten out your left hand, left arm, if you like, and twist under that arm for a bit. Now if you know Urdhva Parshasana, pose. You can keep walking that right hand back over towards the left ankle and make a big twist in the line, or not. This is your variation. And then slowly, pressing into that left hand, inhale, come up. Three cat cows on your own. So you're going to inhale. If you want a meow, go ahead. Inhale to make cow tilt. Exhale, howling cat. That's what you get to meow. You can be a crazy cat or like, you know, tiger. Inhale. Exhale. You can be a, have a big roar. Have your Katy Perry moment. And again, inhale, heartless. Exhale to big meow. And then on your next inhale, it's neutral spine. Left arm stays down, right arm stays down. Inhale, left arm reaches up. Second side, exhale, left shoulder to the floor. Soft eyes, soft jaw. If you'd like to straighten out that arm, go ahead. You can spin under the armpit. Ujjayi breath. More variation. That right arm. Inhale, make your way up. Good. Go ahead and tuck your toes. Downward facing dog. And this down dog is going to be your great release into the low back. So as you check your stance, so arm bones are strong. We're going to take two of those lion's breaths, or those collie breaths together. So we're going to inhale, come onto the balls of the feet, close our eyes. Exhale, heels to the floor, let it go. Anything that you're holding on to in this moment that doesn't serve you. One more time, inhale, come onto the balls of the feet. Exhale, heels to the floor. Beautiful. Inhale, come to plank. Exhale, all the way down. Make a pillow with your hands, forehead down. And you can relax here, or you're going to bend your knees and windshield wiper your shins side to side. That moment for me, when I feel like I kind of really touched into that Bhava of Krishna, right, that Krishna consciousness, is realizing, like, can I show up fully for my whole life? Can we show up fully for this part of the practice? Legs to floor. Hands are under shoulders. So go ahead, point your feet. We're going to walk the feet to the edges of the mat. As your hands are under your shoulders, you're going to point your feet. Take your feet to the corners of your mat. So you're going to take the feet really wide. Hands over the shoulders, forehead down. So this is the Bhujangasana of offering. Okay? As we inhale, we're going to slowly press into the hands. Lift your heart, tailbone's long. Shoulder blades are down the back, belly back, curl back, pelvis down. Take a deep inhale. Make this the offering from the heart. Exhale, bow it in. So as you exhale, maybe you stay here. Or you're going to add one more, okay, before we move on. We're going to inhale, pelvis down, lift the heart. Spinal wave. Can I make this come from these deeper parts of who I am? Exhale, making your wave down. Beautiful. Your right hand is going to reach out onto the floor by your side. Palm is down, the arm is straight. You want your hand level with your eyebrows. Right, left hand is going to come under your left shoulder. So we're doing another shoulder stretch. Opening the front of the heart in a different way, pectoralis major minor. Now go ahead and push into the left hand. And you start to roll towards the right, coming onto the right arm, the right leg. Maybe the left leg lifts. Maybe the left foot lands on the floor. Maybe reach for that back hand, your phantom arm behind you. Maybe not. The right cheek can be down. Find your hands. Yeah. Take an inhale. Now exhale. Release what you have. And we'll switch sides. Left arm out on the floor. Palm is down. Right hand under right shoulder. Left cheek to the floor. Inhale. Push into your right hand. Peel open. Soften into your own heart in the back side. We often forget about the back of the heart. And the front gets all the attention, right? Beautiful. Take another inhale here. Exhale, release. Beautiful. Now, we've got a couple choices here. You're either going to stay with those cobras that we did. If Dhanurasana is not a great choice for your knees, right? If you have ACL issues or patellar tendon issues, okay? Otherwise, we're going to take Dhanurasana bow pose. So we're going to look down, and we're going to reach back to grab our ankles or the tops of our feet. And don't come up yet, okay? And so this is this beautiful moment of being in this seat of devotion, right? Radha Krishna. Now, as you inhale, you're going to lift your heart. You're going to kick back, curl back Dhanurasana, or it's your cobra pose, okay? Now, pelvis into the floor, tailbone long, belly back, curl back. So even with your belly on the floor, can you take Uddiyana Bandha? Draw in, belly back, curl back, lift the heart. Offer it up. Take an inhale. Side ribs breathe. Side rib breathing. Take an inhale. Deep breath in. Exhale. Slowly release it down. Now, some of you might want to press through a vinyasa. Chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Come back to plank and then onto your belly or a pillow. Forehead down, windshield wipers. Now, if anything I say sounds like just bananas, like you skip it, yeah? Okay. Sometimes it's like science fiction, right? And so you just kind of move on. But we all are in these moments together, yeah? So let's do one more before we go onto our back. Can I open the door to my own heart? Bend your knees. You ready? All right. Try to activate your fourth and fifth toe in this posture. It's going to be amazing. You're going to inhale, kick open, lift your heart. Dhanu Rasana. Both. Imagining you're like wrong, right, with this bow. Just like, ready. Right? Aiming true. Can I aim true? Right here. Take an inhale. Pelvis down. Pelvis down. Belly back. Curl back. Take an inhale. Exhale, slowly release it down. That's beautiful. You're just going to simply, super simple, roll onto your back. And it's like a mini shavasana. It's not shavasana, it's pretend shavasana. You're going to close your eyes. Close your eyes. And just pause. Even out your breath. Samadhi, equal parts breath. Practice, it makes us so much more resilient, right? So we can be in these moments in our lives where we can handle it. We can handle expansion, right? You can handle expansive moments. You're more resilient in these moments when everything falls apart, because it will, right? But we can be there now. We can be there present. Now your choice here is to, you know, rest here beautifully for a moment. Or we're going to take a couple of either bridge poses or Urdhva Dhanurasana as an offering to this practice, to Bhaktifest, to this great desert, this Joshua Tree canyon of love, right? This moment. Can I make this an offering? That full, like, offering up. All right. So as you bend your knees for bridge pose, the feet are going to be underneath the knees, arms are by sides. Then you can also just hang out in a chilled out bridge pose. Or hands are going to come over shoulders, Urdhva Dhanurasana, elbows hug in. For bridge, you're going to talk, you're going to drop your tailbone, low belly tones. And as you inhale, you're going to lift your hips. Maybe you interlace your hands behind your back, showing shoulders under. Or as you inhale, Urdhva Dhanurasana, upward facing bow. Toes to midline, okay? Drop your tailbone. Now zipper the knees, right? Root down, so heels down, belly back, curl back. So even in Urdhva Dhanurasana, there's a belly back, curl back into the heart. Yeah, bridge pose, same thing, root down. And then releasing when you're ready, when it's your time, you're gonna release. Arms overhead for bridge, heels off the floor, or Urdhva Dhanurasana, tuck your chin along the way. And then slowly melting down. Coming up one or two more times. Hands over shoulders. Inhaling, coming up. Okay. So if you're in Urdhva Dhanurasana or bridge pose, you're gonna bring your toes to point forward. Okay? So thigh bones parallel. You might soften your glutes, zipper your knees, heels down, big toe down, belly back, curl back into the heart. Offer it up. Yeah. Find the midline. Can you hug the midline here? Find that midline. Beautiful. And then slowly releasing down. We're going to meet up in Sutta Baddha Konasana. So feet are together like butterfly pose in kids yoga. Knees apart. Right hand on your heart. Left hand on your belly. Close your eyes. So we all have these pivotal moments, right? Like being in the chariot, Arjuna and Krishna, right? That moment where time stands still. And this practice gets us ready for that, right? It gets us ready to light up when it's time. When it's our time to light up, we're ready. And I just got a nice little approval on that one, yeah. Okay. When you're ready to bring your knees together, you're going to slowly bring your knees together and hug your knees in. You might go in little circles, little hip circles, whatever you need here. We're going to do some really sweet releasing for the low back after back bends. It's my favorite moment in practice. You're going to keep your right knee into your chest, and your left leg is going to go to the floor. Give your right knee a really good squeeze. Maybe interlace the hands around the right shin, hug it in. Yeah? And then it's half-happy baby pose. You're going to take the sole of the right foot towards the sky. The left leg is going to stay down. Knee towards armpit, perhaps. Sole of the foot to the sky. Ardha Ananda Balasana. So we're going to reset the hips. We're going to bring that femur head back into the back plane. And we're going to draw ourselves back into the fruit of our body, right? Go ahead, bend your left knee. Your left foot's going to come to the floor. You're going to take your right ankle across your left knee or thigh. Eye at the needle pose. So you're going to reach through that triangle that you've created, interlace your hands behind your shin, hug the whole thing in. Yeah. Super flex the right foot. Yeah. And then shift your weight to the midline. Now, if you're really open here, if you're feeling more open, these guys are jamming out and loving it. You're going to maybe cradle that leg in. Right, cradling that leg in. If not, no worries. So good. It's really special that we have Jacob and Maz here today. So just really opening to their sound vibration. Release the grip of your hands. Now listen, the right knee crosses all the way over the left knee like you're going to sit at a fancy dinner. Or maybe it's like an eagle pose wrap, right? So you might do a full eagle wrap or half wrap. Twisted root. Both knees go over to the left. You're going to tee out your arms, look to the right. Soft eyes, soft jaw. Can I be in a place where I'm not resisting my own life, right? That's when you kind of get your life back. Inhale, knees to center. Unravel your legs. Right leg to the floor, left knee hugs in. So interlace the hands, knees in on the left shin. Right leg is long, hug it in. Body Krishna. Soul foot shines to sky. Half happy baby pose, Ardha Ananda Balasana. And just breathing into this space. Like breathing into that space, yeah. You guys are awesome. The right knee will bend, left ankle to right knee. Interlacing the hands around that right shin. Tailor stretch or pigeon prep. Yeah. Interlacing the hands, yeah. Super flex left foot. Shift your weight to the midline, yeah, so you're not missing out. And then breathing. Softening where you need to soften. Release the grip of your hands. Left knee crosses over the right knee. Maybe eagle wrap or half wrap, twisted root knees. Legs to the floor. The knees are going to sink over to the right. You're going to tee out your arms. Look to the left. Yeah. A sweet little twist. Inhaling to center, unraveling your legs, knees to chest. We're going to rock and roll our way up to seated, or you're just going to make your way up to seated, and you're going to spin yourself around just to face in this direction over here. Ardha Matsyajasana. Hello. right foot to left hip. Left foot's going to cross over. Yeah, if this bothers your knee, you can also take the foot inside. Yeah? So taking your arm behind you, left arm behind you, go ahead and wrap the shoulder blade down the back first. And then, as you inhale, the right arm will float, exhaling, twisting towards your bent knee. Big toe reaches into the floor, so we're all twisting towards our left. Sit bones down, belly back, collarbones widen, yeah. Now as you inhale, slowly unravel. Both hands are going to go over to the right. It's a counter lean, a little counter sweep moment of leaning in. And as you inhale, slowly coming up. So your left hand's going to come under your left knee. And you're going to spin your leg open to your left. And you're going to be facing your left. Yeah. So this is kind of a funky pose. It's like Parvrita Janishirsasana. Hi, Kitty. I'll sit on Kitty's mat. So you're going to be folding forward over like your front ankles. You're actually going to the middle of your mat as opposed to going over the legs. You're going to inhale, get long, tailbone long. As you exhale, you're going to fold forward but over your right ankle. Does that make sense? It's weird. You're just going to fold it. Then you're going to go, yeah, it's funky. So we're getting into, we're going to go there next. But yeah, in a second. Yeah. Notice of your inner right hip. Now inhale, slowly make your way up. Your right arm is going to float overhead. Take a deep breath, inhale. As you exhale, you're going to reach over towards your left leg, side body long. Parvrita Janishirsasana. Yeah. Opening up the side of the heart. Beautiful. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, belly spine, arm to sky. Inhale, come all the way up. Swing your legs out in front of you, shake them out. Ardha Mottasana drops in a second chime. Yeah. You guys are with me? With me? Okay. So left knee bends, left foot to right hip, right foot crosses over. Yeah, elbows long. Hand behind you. Inhale, left arm floats. Exhale, twisting towards your right knee. Collarbones wide. Inhale, get long, spacious, collarbone spreading. Exhale, twisting open. Inhale, slowly unravel. Both hands land over the left, counter lean. Inhale. And then slowly inhaling your way up. Right hand under right knee. You're going to swing your leg out open towards the desert. So you're going to take Janishirsasana variation. Right leg's going to go wide. We're going to do our funky fold, so I can thank teacher Christina for this one. You're going to inhale, get long. As you exhale, you're going to fold over that left ankle in the midline. It's weird. Yeah. Forward fold. Beautiful. Now inhale, walk your way up. Left arm floats, take a deep breath. Exhale, reach and lean, reach and lean. Yeah, it's a big side stretch. Yeah, try to keep that right knee tapped to the sky. Yeah. Beautiful. Exhale, belly is fine, arm to sky. Inhale, come all the way up. Both legs out in front of you, facing Maz and Jacob. Shake out your legs. Paschimottanasana. So this is that great bowing in. All right, legs are out. If you can, activate your quads. So the top secret to Paschimo is if you can activate your quadriceps, the hamstrings can let go. And then try Uddiyana Bandha. It's a big vacuum belly, yeah? Inhale, get long. Exhale, fold. Can you hear this music with your inner ear? Can you hear this sound with your inner ear? Beautiful. pause. Your next inhale, it's a slow inhale up. We have two options here for you. You're either going to come into like an early shavasana or it's an inversion. So if you have something that's calling to you like shoulder stand or headstand, this is a great moment for that. Or active reversal. So you might lie on your back and cover your feet over your head like this for a few moments. If you're feeling the call of headstand or shoulder stand, this is that moment. Once you find your way, can you be a vessel for prana? Wherever you are, can you be a vessel for prana? Can we be like in the Bhakti system? Can I be the able vessel where love can manifest? If you've been in headstand, take me a few more moments. It is child's pose. If you've been in shoulder stand, it's going to be like a beastie carriage or bonus. And pulling way onto your back. Twist together before Shavasana. If you've been in child's pose, making your way onto your back, we're going to bring your right knee into the chest. Left leg is going to be long. So if you're still in your practice, stay with it, yeah? Left hand to right knee over to the left. And you're going to tee out your right arm, moving to the right. If you've ever lived in a desert, you know that it's really an ocean. Subterranean ocean happening, especially at night, where all the creatures come out, like the scorpions, the tarantulas, jackrabbits. And as you inhale from the center, and we'll switch sides. Right leg down, left knee in. Right hand to left knee over the right. See out your arm, look to the left. So left arm reach it up. But that's sort of like our own lives, right? Sometimes we dip in, we think it's like this shallow pool, but it's really, right, this deep ocean of bhakti, right? This ocean of devotion. I like to think of it like, you know, just once you dip in, right, you don't leave. But we're here. It's imprinted. Inhale to center, shavasana. We're gonna om together. We're gonna do a little chanting here in a little bit, but we're gonna take one big om together after we clear some space. So arms are gonna be wide. Release your legs. You can take your ankles to the corners of your mat. Your arms are by your sides, out about 45 degrees. Go ahead and take a deep inhale, and you're gonna hold your inhale. So inhale deeply, take a deep breath in, and pause. Dredge up any resistance to the surface. Go ahead, dredge it up a little bit more. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, let it all go. Nothing pretty. Right, nothing is ever that pretty. Go ahead, inhale, take a deep breath, dredge it up. Pause. Get some more air. Take a deep inhale. Exhale. Can I feel this space with my inner vision? Can I hear these sounds with my inner hearing? Can I be in this space of devotion with my innermost heart? And as the tribe comes by again, they might be on their way back. I want you to open to their love. Can we be this vessel of love? And letting everything else fall away. Mm-hmm. to your body in space. Feeling the air on your skin. Feeling the beating of your own heart. Feeling the beating of the drum. Love is manifest where there is an able vessel. As you next inhale, just bring your awareness to your hands, to your feet. And you might start to float your arms overhead for a full body stretch, big, like a cat in the sun, like a lizard in the desert. And then rolling to one side and nourishing yourself there for a moment. Eventually, we're going to push our way up to a comfortable seat. Actually, I love it if you'd all come up here and we're just going to sit together for a moment. So if you're in the yonder regions, just making your way up here, we'll just all kind of gather around together. You can drag a mat or not. Bring something if you like, but just come in close, yeah? They won't bite you. They don't bite. We're going to do a little call and response. This is my innermost joy to do this, just to be in yoga with people. And so once you find your way to your seat, maybe just taking this moment, both hands over your own heart, tuning into your own breath. We're going to drop into Jacob. With your eyes closed for a moment, offer up your love, your full heart of love, to those behind you, those that support you, all these hearts around you, offering up your love to them. To every heart in this great desert, in this great space of God with us, offering it out to them.
Thank you.
dedicating our practice, offering up in some way. Offering up the fruits of our practice to those in need. Roka, Samasa, Sukhina, Bhavantu. May all beings be happy and free. May all beings know peace. May all beings know safety. May all beings live free from fear.
Excellent. That was a really killer one if you want the other half.
Thank you for sharing your heart and your love and sharing what all the way so I also want to thank, you know, Anne and Divinitry and they're sponsoring this tent, and you have this great set of studios here in California. I'd love to see you again. I want to thank Jacob and Mom. Thank you.